The National Economic and Development Authority says its board, which is chaired by President Marcos, has approved some key infrastructure projects, and that includes the Tarlac-Pangasinan-La Union Expressway or TP-LEX extension project. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan shares this is considered as one of the fastest unsolicited proposal approvals. The project is a 59-kilometer expressway which seeks to connect the Ilocos region to Central Luzon and Metro Manila. Balisacan notes the project will be implemented through a public-private partnership.
To recall, these high-impact infrastructure projects are designed to address the nation's infrastructure deficit, thereby driving sustainable economic growth across priority sectors of our economy. In total, the IFPs have an estimated cost of 8.3 trillion pesos. The Marcos administration remains steadfast in its dedication to pursuing projects that are in line with its 8-point socioeconomic agenda and the strategies identified in the Philippine Development Plan 2023 to 2028.
Philippine authorities identify the gunman in the killing of Oriental Mindoro radio broadcaster Crescenciano Bunungkin. Police Colonel Samuel Delorino said they identified the suspect after surveying the motorcycle the perpetrators used. An eyewitness also confirmed the gunman's identity. Delorino clarified the assailant, who died after being hit by a car by Bundukin's son, was only the driver. Delorino said a manhunt is underway for the remaining suspect, who has gone into hiding.
Kahapon ng hapon ay nakuha natin ng statement yung prime witness natin na kung saan ay talagang positively identified na ayun talaga yung nakita niya na bumaril doon sa ating biktima. Itong mga ito ay walang helmet eh. Laman lang na cover sa mukha. Hindi lang po natin muna pangangalanan, sir, yung person of interest natin dahil ongoing pa rin yung ating manhunt operation.
The Philippine Interior Department says the case against Congressman Deves and other suspects remains strong despite the recantations. Interior Secretary Benher Abalos believes no torture was inflicted on the suspects. The police earlier refuted the torture allegations, saying they have a high regard for human rights.
I had a meeting with Secretary of Justice, si Boying. I told him, ito'y na-file na sa inyo, kamusta na ba ang kaso? And he assured me, huwag kang mag-alala, malakas ang kaso. Sabi niya sa akin ganon, despite this recantation. And of course, meron pa tayong ibang demanda labang kay Congressman Teves, kung hindi ako nagkakamali. I think this is in relation to the previous killings wherein he was implicated. At may mga testigo pa rin doon. No?
And the Philippine Justice Secretary doubling down on his claim, suspects in the murder of Provincial Governor Noel De Gamo were paid to recant. Secretary Jesus Crispino de Mulia insisted Friday his information was reliable, coming from the National Bureau of Investigation. Attorney Danny Villanueva, counsel of some suspects, had dismissed that allegation. The suspects earlier identified Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. as the mastermind in the De Gamo killing.
Comes from a very wealthy moneyed source. There was something at stake in the criminal case. We are not surprised by all of these things happening. Sabi nila, there were lawyers. Lawyers were the ones on top of this. And it's really not just one lawyer. Huh? These are lawyers, you know, mga nababayarang tao kasi ito. These are the expensive lawyers probably who are orchestrating the legal defense team for this terrorist group.
The lawyer of another suspect, Marvin Miranda, meanwhile, calls Secretary Remulla's allegation pure hearsay. Now, over in the United States, a highway in Texas turns into a roaring river as heavy rainfall caused flash floods in the city of O'Donnell. Several vehicles can be seen pushed to the side of the highway, with some cars submerged in surging flood water. On Thursday, authorities advised residents to stay off main roads and move to higher ground as the National Weather Service issued flash flood alerts across southern Texas.